we're going.
Hi, this is Mitzie, and we're going to do her little Shih Tzu face in what we call the baseball face, which is a very round little head with a round little muzzle, and it looks adorable on this particular Shih Tzu and on many Shih Tzus. Isn't she cute? We love her little tongue sticking out like that. He says, so precious? Okay. So, I'm going to start by trimming under the eyes, like we always would do. Let's get that excess out of the, in front of the eye and in the corners of the eye. These are little blending shears that have a very narrow little tip, so they're very perfect for just fitting right in on little dog faces like that. Now, one of Mitzie's special features is that she's got pretty dark eyelashes. So we're going to allow her to keep those eyelashes, and just every now and then we trim them a little bit. But they kind of, they're a girly feature for her, so we leave that. Thinning on top of the head. And we could use a four blade on the top of her head and her face. Okay, now we've got a four blade and we're just going to go over the crown of the hair and the ears with a four blade. This dog looks very cute with short, her ears kept short. So we just flatten the ear out in the palm of your hand. It keeps it from accidentally cutting the ear leather. Again, I'm using my fingers as kind of a guide in the backdrop. You could come and get some of this off the side. Now we could actually go right over the muzzle, especially if it's gotten too long, you can do it.
Thank you.
now I'm going to use a regular blending shear to just shape and blend the whole head into a rather round, hopefully round shape. Good girl. Now this style of head is best done often. If you let it get all grown out, it's much harder to shape the little round head. So I actually recommend, if you're grooming your Shih Tzus at home, that you do it every 4 weeks, at least. You could do sooner, but don't let them go 3-4 months and then try to make sense out of it all. You know what I'm saying? It's just too hard to start with a big, all grown out coat. It's better to shave them down and then just kind of let it take shape over again and keep it short. You don't have to keep it. This dog was shaved down when she was taken from rescue, and now we've got her at just like a graceful length. I like that term, graceful length. Good length for Mitzie. We can trim the edge of the ears a little bit, holding the ear leather gently between our fingers and then just scissoring between our fingers. So both my thumb and my finger are on her ear leather at the edge. That's how we keep from cutting the ear. So cute. We define her eyelashes by cutting short kind of behind them. I need an eyelash curler for you, girl. These little tiny mini blenders are the best for getting up in the corner of the eye. Thank you. crazy down there? There she is. Cute little girl. She's a cute little girl, yes. Let's see that. That'd be fun. Anything else I need to clarify? I think that's good. Basic little Shih Tzu head. And the key to keeping this Shih Tzu looking cute is to do her every month. So it doesn't get too unruly and you don't lose your place. And you're just taking off a little bit every time and keeping it all trimmed up nice. So that she's got some coat. Doesn't look like she hasn't got the military cut. She just got a nice and formal, short, easy to care for teddy bear cut. Thank you.